Number 13, the international boy, Liam Stocker. And he's a massive favourite of mine. I just love his story. I love the uniqueness of his experience growing up, living overseas, living in Beijing and Hong Kong. And I just think it's going to bode well for him for many years to come. I think he's got a really good head on his shoulders. And just the way he speaks really excites me. Having a look at his 2019, he made his debut against Collingwood, of all teams. And he didn't look one bit overawed by the moment, and that was really pleasing to see. He's got a lot of, you can just tell he's got a lot of confidence within himself. He reminds me, he has this aggression about him, and it reminds me a little bit of Taylor Adams from Collingwood. He's just got this look in his eyes, and you can just tell he's got a real appetite for the contest. And one thing I've noticed about his preseason this year is just in the match sim, and when he does have the ball and he's playing that inside midfield role, he just really draws that contact. He really enjoys that contact. And I made the comment a few weeks ago about, is that something that's going to be able to, you know, allow him at the stage of his development to play, you know, the 20 games that he'll probably want to play this year or more. And that's just something I'm mindful of, but he looks like he's in ripping condition. He had a bit of a foot issue, which there were a few reports around about how he wasn't disclosing it to the club as best as what he probably should have. And for me, I like it. I mean, a guy just wants to play through pain. Probably goes to show the character that he has. And I would really hope that he can build off the 5 games that he played last year and push into that maybe 10, 11, 12 game bracket this year. And if he's able to do that, already we've added a great layer of depth to the list. And, you know, he was really an afterthought last year. You know, the 5 games, we saw a little bit, but we were left wanting a lot more. And for me, I like the penetrating left foot that he has. I like how he uses the attacking option when he gets the chance. He's not afraid to really try and pinpoint a pass. And Teague talks a lot about backing yourself in. And I think Liam Stocker is going to be someone that really benefits from that. I've seen him do some of the running with the defensive group. Now, I don't know if that's because he's going to be playing across halfback or what that means. But I think that's probably going to be a good apprenticeship for him to then move into the midfield. I just think at this stage, I don't know if he's ready to play in the midfield full-time because of his development, and also because I think there's just probably too many people ahead of him at this stage. But I think across half-back, where he can use his foot skills, which are really good, he's tough, he's competitive, and that bodes well for a defender. And, you know, we've been talking about a potential Cade Simpson replacement, and I think he's one of the few guys that can slot into that role, and then maybe next year or the year after push into the midfield. But I love what I'm seeing from Liam. I just think he's a great guy, great kid, just, you know, listening to the way he speaks and the way he carries himself. And I'm really excited for his 2020. It looks like he's been doing all of the running, the extras. You see the little clips on Instagram. I remember just after the grand final, Daisy Thomas was at the club and he put a video of Liam Stocker doing laps at Icon Park with no one around. So, you know, little things like that. That's what the supporters like to see. That's what I like to see. And hopefully he can have a good run at his health this year and really break in 2020. What about you? How do you think his season's going to play out? Where do you want him to play? Is he a midfielder? Is he ready to go? Is he someone that will play across half back? Let me know in the comments below.